This is a story about sea gypsy vampiress and about wishes and about do they come true. Danny found out one time that if you could catch the moon, you could make a wish. He caught the moon one night and he wondered, is it true what they say about the sea gypsy vampiress? Will she really make your wishes come true? So he set off early the next morning to find the sea gypsy vampiress. He heard that she lived near the sea, through the woods, through a cemetery, dark and mysterious. And you also had to go through a large spider web's nest to her house. When he got there, she wasn't too pleased to see him. She wasn't used to getting company. What is it that I can do for you? Why have you come? You want a wish? From me? I will turn you into a blonde! What? A blonde? What have you done? Hey, wait a minute. Hey, this ain't too bad. Can you change me into a hula girl so I can be lots of fun at parties? What? You question my powers. I can change myself into a hula girl just to show you. Voila! How you like me now? Backside? Huh? Now, do you question me? In order to be a hula girl, she told him, you have to do lots of things. You have to eat the eyes of the snake, lick the skin of a toad, eat magic mushrooms, eat the ribs of a lizard, the wings of a dragonfly, and a dead baby puppy. And let's not forget the head of a cockatiel. So he did. He even ate it with bread. He ate the bread and he drank her potion. Matter of fact, he had a second helping. Ate it like soup. Not bad. Abracadabra, hocus pocus! Hula girl you are! Holy smokes! Speaking of which, she even put a cigarette in my hand. How can this be? You must be a super vampiress. I am a sea gypsy vampiress. I can do lots of things. I can put people in boxes and keep them there. I make them make photos and serve coffee. And I can even change people into little people. So little that they can pick seeds off the watermelon. I can also make them so small that they draw the circles on the mushrooms. Well, if you ask me, I think I'm happy being a hula girl. What? But I can do other stuff. I can change you into a birthday boy. Oh my God. But it's not my birthday. Hello, did you hear me? It's not my birthday. Don't make me get irate. The sea gypsy told him, drink more potion and dance around a fire. That will change you back. So Danny began drinking with the closest fairy that was in the room, which was the wood fairy. She too was drinking. She said that she would dance with her partners around the fire to break the spell. Which they danced. And they danced. They danced until they couldn't dance anymore. They danced until the wisest fairy stopped them. The wisest? But if you're so wise, where's the food? If you're so wise. Well, just use your eyes, young man, she says. Can't you see them? They're cooking. Within seconds, the spell was starting to break. And you could see that. From then on, he just went and enjoyed the rest of the party with the fairies. And then the next morning, things were coming out as usual. He was a very happy camper at this point. He wanted to go to the beach. He wanted to point out a few things. He wanted to see if he could change the sea gypsy into a seagull. Poof! She thought she had powers. Well, just goes to show you. Get changed into a hula girl. Eat all the stuff. Change yourself back. You can do all that. You gotta be magical. It's all in a day's work.